dude. No, sir, you may not have the last banana. That one is for me. Oh!
Whoa, Willard. What's going on here?
Well, this is the last banana, and I really, really want it, so I wasn't gonna give it out today, but he grabbed it.
Yeah, and what did you do?
I grabbed it out of his hand. It's my banana, and I want it.
Willard, hold on. Did you use kind words and ask him to please put it back?
Well, I... Oh, no, I don't think I did.
Willard, it kind of sounds like you didn't use self-control with your words or in the way that you acted.
Kyle, what's self-control?
Self-control means that you don't let your angry words come out and you are gentle with your actions. It means you do the right thing, even if it's hard.
Oh, I definitely did not do that. I used mean words and I grabbed the banana from that man.
Willard, did you know that the Holy Spirit can help you with self-control?
He can?
Yeah, because self-control is one of the fruit of the Spirit.
Oh, I remember all of them. Let's see, there was love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness.
And the last one is self-control. Self-control is important because it helps us to share the love of God with others through the way we act. You know, I think we should learn more about self-control today. Hey, let's all say, I have self-control. Ready?
I have self-control.
All right, let's go look at what the Bible says about self-control.
Hi, friends. It's me, Margaret. I'm so happy you're all here today. We're learning about self-control. Have you ever played with a little remote-controlled car before? You had the remote and you were telling the car where to go? Oh, those are so cool to play with. Those are cool because we're controlling the car or we're telling it what to do. Well, we're not talking about us being controlled by a remote, but we're talking about self-control. That means we're controlling our actions and the way we act. Like when my older brother is annoying me, I might want to push him. But I don't do that because it's mean. I control my actions. I say to myself, no, I'm not gonna push him. Self-control is hard sometimes. I'm not always good at it. That's why I need help from the Holy Spirit. When we make Jesus the leader of our lives, the Holy Spirit comes into our lives and he helps us. He helps us with all the fruit of the Spirit. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. So today let's learn, I have self-control. Say it with me. I have self-control. There's a Bible story about a man named David who had to use self-control. We can find it in the Old Testament in 1 Samuel 24. Remember, this is a true story from the Bible. It really happened. Two men named David and Saul were fighting. One of them wanted to hurt the other one. So David was running away, and Saul chose a bunch of men to go with him to find David and hurt him. At the place where the road passes some sheepfolds, Saul went into a cave. But as it happened, David and his men were hiding further back in that cave. David was already in the cave that Saul went into, and Saul didn't see David. I wonder what will happen. Do you think David will try to stop Saul from hurting him? Now's your opportunity, David's men whispered to him. Today the Lord is telling you, I will certainly put your enemy into your power to do with as you wish. So David crept forward and cut off a piece of the hem of Saul's robe. Whoa! David didn't hurt Saul. He used self-control. He only ripped off a piece of Saul's clothes. I wonder why. But then David's conscience began bothering him because he had cut Saul's robe. He said to his men, "The Lord forbid that I should do this to my lord the king. I shouldn't attack the Lord's anointed one, for the Lord himself has chosen him." So David restrained his men and did not let them hurt Saul. After Saul had left the cave and gone on his way, David came out and shouted after him, "My lord the king!" And when Saul looked around, David bowed low before him. David could have been showing him the piece of clothing and saying, ha ha, see, I could have hurt you, but I didn't. Instead, he used self-control again. He controlled his actions and the way he was acting. He bowed before Saul. Then he shouted to Saul, why do you listen to the people who say I'm trying to harm you? This very day you can see with your eyes it isn't true. For the Lord placed you at my mercy back there in the cave. Some of my men told me to hurt you, but I spared you. For I said, I will never harm the king. He is the Lord's anointed one. Look, my father, at what I have in my hand. It is a piece of the hem of your robe. I cut it off, but I didn't hurt you. This proves that I'm not trying to harm you and that I have not sinned against you, even though you have been hunting for me to hurt me. David didn't hurt Saul, even though he could have. He listened to God and God was telling him not to hurt Saul. He used self-control. I wonder if David was sitting there and asking God to help him have self-control. We can learn to ask God for help with our self-control. I have self-control. Say it with me. I have self-control. When we start feeling that feeling of wanting to do something wrong, we can stop and ask the Holy Spirit to help us. We can say, Holy Spirit, help me do the right thing, and He will help us. I have to use self-control when I want to take a cookie, even though my mom told me to wait until after dinner. I just love cookies so much. But I have to ask the Holy Spirit to help me listen to my mom and do the right thing. Do you ever feel that way? You want to do something wrong even though you know you shouldn't? We all feel that, but the Holy Spirit can help us with self-control. We can do the right thing instead. I have to also use self-control when I'm waiting in line to go outside to play or waiting in line to go down the slide. I really want to push my friends out of the way so I can go first, but I have to do the right thing. I have to wait and use self-control. I always have to ask the Holy Spirit to help me have more and more self-control. I have self-control. Say that with me again. I have self-control. Thanks for joining me today, friends. Don't forget to practice self-control. Bye!
Wow, David could have done something really mean or bad to Saul, couldn't he have?
He could have, but he didn't. He listened to God and used self-control.
Oh, that's good. I wouldn't want him to do something wrong.
Well, you know, we all do things that are wrong. But when we start feeling that feeling of wanting to do something wrong or being mean or not kind, we can stop and ask the Holy Spirit to help us to be more like Jesus.
Can we pray and ask the Holy Spirit to help us?
Yep. But we can say, Holy Spirit, help me have self-control and do what is right.
You know, I think next time I start feeling that angry feeling and being not kind to others, I'm gonna pray that.
That's a good idea. Hey, maybe you wouldn't have been so mean to the man who wanted your last banana. Hey, let's all say our special one thing together. I have self-control. You ready?
I have self-control. Maybe it's time to try something other than this fruit stand.
You know, I bet there are a lot of adventures that we could go on.
I love adventures.
Hey kids, I'm Christy. Before we end today, let's practice our memory verse and pray. Galatians 5:22-23. But the Holy Spirit produces this kind of fruit in our lives. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Let's all say, I have self-control, like you're holding a controller. Ready? I have self-control. Let's all pray. Put your hands together and bow your head. Dear God, thank you so much for loving us and giving us the Holy Spirit so we can be more like you, so we can show love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. We want to love you every day. Amen.